Hi everyone! I am getting ready to do my very first listen to The Beach Boys, and Vlad tells me this is among his list of the classics. So I'm very curious to see what it's like and so forth. Now, I don't know anything. I've heard this name, The Beach Boys. As I said in the announcement, I know enough to know that they are a musical group. I don't know their placement in the history of rock music. And because I haven't read anything about them, done any research yet, neither have I gotten started on this other project, which I have mentioned before, that I'm going to be going through the history of rock with an expert rock musician historian. So I'm kind of coming at this out of the blue, out of context. But I kind of think that's fun too. So I'm just going to take it as it is, let it go, and see what happens and see what I think of it. And I hope you can enjoy my journey. Here we go. I'm thinking about this whole world. It's very happy and vacation-y sounding. I feel like maybe I should be driving down the road in a little retro convertible with a couple other friends and the radio on and something like that. It's cute. It's fun. Got a little bit of a vocal flourish at the end. Oh, fun. It was kind of fun. All right, I'm going to back up just a little bit. A little bit of a mood shift there. Working with the text a bit. I see love. I see love. When girls get mad at boys and go, many times they're just putting on a show. But when they leave, it's going along nicely, and I can hear how they're taking sensitive little adjustments to paint the picture. I wouldn't say that it sounds like really profound music or, you know, some deep work of art, but it's nice, and it does a nice job so far of giving this nice quality to it. Many times they're just putting on a show, but when they leave you wait alone. This little phrase that's being repeated. Well, I have to confess, I'm not good at picking out and understanding the words in this style of music. And it's so funny to me because if I listen to a piece of, let's say, English choral music, I know exactly what they're saying all the way through. And I've had lots of people tell me they can't understand. They can't follow that music, the words, what it's saying. They have to have the text in front of them. And now I feel myself on the other side where I can't understand. And so I hear this fun little sort of ostinato happening in the voices, but I can't quite make out what the word is that they're saying. And it's not written in my text here. So I'm hearing it as a sort of rhythmic feature, which is nice and I enjoy it. But that's just something that I can't pick out right now. I'll have to try to figure out what it is later. And I noticed, too, that this same little repeated phrase that the voices are doing is working with the drum that's happening underneath. Bum, 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 bum. And the drum is doing almost the same thing underneath. And it sets a balance from the top down to the bottom. And the voice is just flowing and being free in the middle of this scene here. Wish they didn't fade out at the end, because I was so enjoying the different textures and layers happening. Let me just back up a little bit and hear that ending again. Late at night, I think about the love of this whole world. Very nice. Very nice. I like it. Towards the end there, I was feeling like they're so precise and together in the way they're working their voices, and they're working so well. They don't even need the instruments to give the energy of the song. The instruments are just adding layers of texture and color around, but the voices, this group of voices, I don't even know how many are singing here and how much of it is dubbed over multi-tracks, or is it a group that just sings all together? But I like the precision of their singing. I like it a lot. And this brings me back to a group that I've mentioned before, which is the King's Singers. And that's one of the reasons I've always been attracted to the King's Singers' music. They don't use instruments. They're a cappella, just without instruments. And they do everything with their voice. But it is precise down to the millisecond of diction, and of course their pitch is impeccable and all of that. And I'm hearing the same sort of precision in this group. And I enjoy it. And I feel like it does a great job of taking this simple, happy little tune and making it something that you can just sit back and have fun with. And every little moment is placed just so to help us relax and enjoy the atmosphere. I heard a little bit of the drums underneath, kind of like just holding things going. and some other simple instruments. I didn't notice any guitar. Did I miss it? Or was I just so fascinated by the voices that I didn't hear it? And there wasn't a guitar solo, as far as I know. So it's a short little tune. I guess it's not even 2 minutes long. And so it comes and goes quickly. Probably, from what I've gathered, a very good radio song, like a lot of these rock musicians did for the radio. And it's cute, it's fun, I like it. I'm going to dig in and explore and see what I can learn about the band and maybe see if I can give some more insights into any little musical features, but I enjoyed it. To my new subscribers, if you want to receive notifications when I post new content, you can activate that by clicking this little bell next to the subscribe button. If you enjoy my work and want to support this channel, check out my Ko-fi page. It's like Patreon, but I think better. You will find several different ways to stay in touch or contribute to the development of this community there. And click this link to watch the second half of this Beach Boys experience, where I give further thoughts and insights and we study the music a bit together. I'll see you soon.